Hi guys, Dave here. I'm going to show you how I make my kombucha. Now, unfortunately, I can't really show you from the beginning because I basically need a real camera to do that. But I'm going to loop you in and show you what I can. So in here, in my cabinet, is my SCOBY, and in here is some finished kombucha, and this SCOBY here is a culture. Essentially, it's covered with a paper towel, and it's secured by a rubber band. The reason why there is a paper towel here is because you need something that's breathable, because this culture, we're going to take this off, is living. Yes, it's live. It's a SCOBY, a symbiotic colony of bacteria and yeast. I know it sounds disgusting. However, if you are a kombucha brewer, you probably think that this is beautiful. So the finished kombucha is going to be poured into this jug, which has been sterilized. We have a funnel, and we're going to pour this into that, and then we're going to take this, which is sweetened black tea. And what I did earlier, and this is the part that I was not able to show you, I took sugar in the raw, and I took bottled water, well, spring water, a gallon of it, and I mixed it all together, and I just let several bags of black tea steep in here. You want a straight kind of tea. It can be straight black tea, straight green tea, pu'er tea, whatever it happens to be, it's fine. But do not use Earl Grey because of the bergamot in there. Don't use herbal tea because what'll happen is this will start to grow mold because the pH balance is gonna be off and it's, you know, your SCOBY is gonna be ruined. So rule, always use a straight tea. So I poured what I could into the bottle, and you want to leave a little bit of the kombucha still in the glass jar. And what I then did was I poured the sweet tea into here, so the culture is basically going to be feeding on the sugar. That's what keeps it alive, that's what keeps it healthy, and you want to cover it back up. Now I want to just say that the tea that was over there is room temperature, maybe a little warm. You do not want to you know, boil up the water, steep the tea, and then put it in here because you will kill the SCOBY. The SCOBY is a living creature. So you have to treat it like a living creature. And so room temp is it. The other thing is that you wanna have at least a good 1.5, 2 inches of air. Why? Because you want it to breathe. It's a living creature. So we have the sweet tea with filtered water, spring water. I wouldn't use distilled water because that's a little, there's a reason why you shouldn't use that. I don't remember what it was and I apologize for that, but use spring water. That's the best that you can use. And you can use regular sugar if you want. However, I like to use sugar in the raw because it is healthier overall. I hate white sugar. It is nasty. I don't even put it in my coffee. So anyway, here we go. So we've got that. And what you're then going to do is put in your cabinet and put her to bed and leave her for a few weeks, and there you go. However, for this lady here, she produces kombucha pretty fast, so I guarantee you she'll be ready in about probably a week and a half. The other thing to point out too, I'm a chatterbox, is that for every batch you do, she's going to grow another layer because SCOBYs are living organisms and they grow. And at this point in time, I can start investing in other mason jars and, you know, start producing more kombucha, basically. And the other thing that I want to just say to you as well is that with the leftover tea, You want to save this for two reasons. Number one, let's just say you're really craving the kombucha, you really want some, and you don't have time to brew up the tea. Well, guess what? You're going to have tea that you can store right in here, so you can literally pour it right in the bottle. The other thing is that what you can do, pour them in here. You're going to want to make sure you have some room for air. You're going to want to seal them so that they are completely airtight. What you will do is put them in here in the dark. Oh, one more. And then within a few weeks, you are going to have tea soda because it will carbonate and it will ferment. No, there is no trace of any SCOBY in here or any bacteria. It's just the sweet tea, but for whatever reason, it ferments. And now for the part that I've been waiting for all day. So, now, this is what's known as, I believe, a primary fermentation, or, you know, it's a first fermentation. Now with this, if you want to flavor your kombucha, you know, you can add to the finished product, okay? You do not want to put it in the SCOBY because otherwise, you know, the SCOBY could get moldy. It's just not going to be a good thing. That is always straight tea. That is it. Whatever tea you want, but it has to be a straight tea. It's got to be green, black, pu'er, white is okay. Do not use an herbal. And do not use a blend, unless it happens to be, you know, black and green. I'm not even sure. Look it up on Google. All right, so, but what I'm going to do, I'm not going to actually do another fermentation, but what I am going to do is this. Doesn't that sound good? I'm going to flavor this with a little bit of apple cider. Because I can. And stir and enjoy. Wow, wow, wow. That is very, very good. So, there you have it. I just turned over a batch of kombucha and discovered a really good recipe too. Take your primary batch, add a little bit of apple cider, serve on the rocks.